The industry is the controlled environment agricultural industry, and it's focused mainly in urban and peri-urban areas where there's either a lack of land or an excess of underutilized building space. And it's a question of being able to grow as much as possible in those areas.
A new kind of biotechnology is giving fresh meaning to the phrase farm to table. Built by a Boston startup called Freight Farms, the Leafy Green Machine is a hydroponic grow space built into a repurposed shipping container and optimized to grow lettuce and leafy greens. It's been purchased by restaurants, food service companies, farms, schools, and it offers a look at just what it takes to turn a cool idea into a transformative product powerful enough to change agriculture as we know it.
Over time, we kind of got away from the greenhouse structure and started to look for something that was a little bit more uniform. Really was just like, I think there's something around shipping containers, and then merging that with the idea of local crop production. It really wasn't until we built it, until we just had that moment of confirmation that this is it.
The origin of Freight Farms was really trying to look at the problem of growing food closer to where people are, and there just not being an available solution.
The farm's portability changes all that. A company called Greenline Growers, for instance, is located in an old taxi depot just off of Beacon Street, the main commercial strip in Brookline, Massachusetts. Founded by Christopher Muddy and Robert Zucker, Greenline is just starting out, selling mostly to restaurants and private chefs.
The real key for a restaurant is we'll go and bring them, you know, boxes of samples, but it's getting them here to see what we're doing, to taste it, to feel it, to kind of help us select the type of seeds we should be planting that they're going to want.
Each container costs $80,000 to purchase and approximately $1,000 a month to operate, not including land rental. It's designed to be predictable. Some farms run on as little as 10 gallons of water and 8 kilowatt hours of energy a day, only about 2.5 times the energy consumption of a typical American home.
To really make it compete with the global food system, we had to make a compelling financial argument that local has a viable business opportunity.
You want to be able to give people a formula that they can really run with. So if we tell them, do 15 to 20 hours of this type of labor and you will get, you know, 800 heads of this type of lettuce. You know, somebody who's off the street and just wants to start their local food business can really plan around that.
Freight Farms provides new farmers with training and, crucially, the basic outline of a business plan to get them going.
I was looking at people's discussions about growing in cities, particularly one by the Conservation Law Foundation, which analyzed how much you could grow in the existing space that was available in cities. It struck me that it really wasn't very much.
Before becoming a freight farmer, Cooney built and sold several software companies. He successfully lobbied the city of Boston to allow urban farming, researched the industry, did his due diligence on the Leafy Green Machine, crunched the numbers, and with his wife Connie, bought 5 containers, founding a new company, Cornerstalk Farms.
You know, what we realized is, even though this is technology and the use of technology, a lot of what we're doing and knowledge around it is been done before. What you need to do to make sure the product is really good and is all standard farm knowledge.
He installed his containers in a tow yard in East Boston in 2013. It's fertile ground for Cornerstalk. The company is currently producing 4,000 heads of lettuce per week, which Cooney thinks he can increase by as much as 20%.
We're basically bringing in somewhere around $16,000 a month. It's self-sustaining, we're making a little bit of money, and we're actually, you know, looking at moving to secure the profitability of the business and expand.
What we suggest and what we try to lean to is bringing performance to the lay folk and making that easy, automating those settings. That's where people are going to take it from, oh, I'm a hobby grower, I have a garden, I grow a few things, and really cross over into, I can farm as a business.
If you have a, you know, modular node of commercial production that can be run by somebody who's simply motivated, it really opens up a world of possibilities.